Alfie Gets In First by Shirley Hughes. One day, Alfie and Mum and Aunt Rose were coming home from the shops. Alfie ran on ahead because he wanted to get home first. He ran all the way from the corner to the front gate and up the front steps to the door. Then he sat down on the top step and waited for the others. Along came Mum, pushing Aunt Rose and the shopping.
"I raced you," called Alfie. "I'm back first, so there."
Aunt Rose didn't care. She was tired. She sat back in her pushchair and sucked her thumb. Mum put the brake on the pushchair and left Aunt Rose at the bottom of the steps while she lifted the basket of shopping up to the top. Then she found the key and opened the front door. Alfie dashed in ahead of her.
"I've won! I've won!" he shouted.
Mum put the shopping down in the hall and went back down the steps to lift Aunt Rose out of her pushchair. But what do you think Alfie did then? He gave the door a great big slam. Bang! Just like that. Then Mum was outside the door holding Aunt Rose, and Alfie was inside with the shopping. Mum's key was inside too. "Open the door, Alfie," said Mum. But Alfie didn't know how to open the door from the inside. The catch was too high up. Mum looked into the letterbox. "Try and reach the catch and turn it," she said. Alfie tried, but he couldn't quite reach it. "Can you put the key through the letterbox?" said Mum. But Alfie couldn't reach the letterbox either. Aunt Rose was hungry as well as tired. She began to cry. Then Alfie began to cry too. He didn't like being all by himself on the wrong side of the door. Just then, Mrs. McNally came hurrying across the street to see what all the noise was about. She and Mum took it in turns to say encouraging things into the letterbox. But Alfie still couldn't open the door. "Go and fetch your little chair from the sitting room and then you'll be able to reach the catch," said Mum. He just went on crying louder and louder, and Aunt Rose cried louder and louder too.
"There's my Maureen," said Mrs. McNally. "I'm sure she'll be able to help."
Mrs. McNally's Maureen was a big girl. Right away, she came and joined Mum and Aunt Rose and Mrs. McNally on the top step.
"Might have to break a window," she said. "But I'll try and climb up the drain pipe first if you'd like." But Mrs. McNally didn't like that idea at all.
"Oh no, Maureen, you might hurt yourself," she said.
Just then, Alfie's very good friend, the milkman, came up the street in his milk float. When he saw Mum and Aunt Rose and Mrs. McNally and Mrs. McNally's Maureen all standing on the top step, he stopped his float and said,
"What's the trouble?"
So they told him.
"Don't worry, mate," the milkman shouted. "We'll soon have you out of there." "Looks as though this lock's going to be difficult to break," said the milkman.
But then Mrs. McNally's Maureen had a very good idea. She ran to ask the window cleaner, who was working up the street, if he would bring his ladder
and climb up to the bathroom window. And, of course, when the window cleaner heard about Alfie, he came hurrying along with his ladder as quickly as he could. Then Mum and Andrews and Mrs. McNally and Mrs. McNally's Maureen and the milkman all stood on the top step and watched while the window cleaner put his ladder up against the house. He started to climb up to the bathroom window. But when he was halfway up the ladder, what do you think happened? The front door suddenly opened and there was Alfie. He had managed to reach the catch and turn it like that after all. He was very pleased with himself. He opened the front door as wide as it would go and stood back grandly to let everybody in. Then the window cleaner came down from his ladder and he and the milkman and Mrs. McNally's Maureen and Mrs. McNally and Andrews and Mum and Alfie all went into the kitchen and had tea together.